Hello students, in the last session we saw some of the properties of operational amplifier or op amp. So the properties are nothing but bandwidth, slew rate, settling time, then output impedance, input impedance. Now in this class you will see the other properties such as common mode rejection ratio, such as other properties such as common mode, we call it as common mode rejection ratio, and second one is power supply rejection ratio, third one is offset and drips. These are the three properties we are going to see in this class. Before that let me explain bandwidth. In the last class I told you bandwidth is nothing but In the last class, I told you bandwidth. Bandwidth is nothing but a range of frequencies over which my operational amplifier works. So, if I take here, if I take x-axis as frequency or time and y-axis as gain, normally gain is expressed as I said in the previous class over decibel, and we know what is decibel. Decibel is nothing but 20 log. It is nothing but 20 log AD. This is decibel. So at zero frequency or at lower frequency, normally if you take, this is our gain. After certain frequency, our gain will reduce 3 dB, and it will reduce further if you increase the frequency. And this reduction is something 20 dB. This is 20 dB per decade. This is called as 20 dB per decade, or minus 6 dB per octave. These are the two parameters we use, minus 6 dB for octave. 20 dB decade means we plot this frequency over decade scale. If you start, this is 1, this is 10, this is 100, this is 1000, this is 10,000, so on. So the gain decreases 20 dB per decade. For example, if F1 is my frequency, at F1 the gain is 100 dB. Now, at 10 F1, my gain is 80 dB. It is decreased by 20 dB per decade. If you take the other parameter is used to express when my frequency double, that is, initially my frequency is F1. After that, my frequency double means 2F1. After that, my frequency double means 4F1. This is, in order to express this one, we are using dB, I mean octave scale. So, at F1, it is 100. Then, at 2F1, it is 94 dB. At 4F1, it is 88. It is 88 dB per octave. So, this is the scale we use, this is the parameter we use to express the gain. So, with this friends, we will now proceed to the other one, that is called as a CMRR. What is CMRR? Common mode rejection ratio. We know the gain AD. We know the gain AD is nothing but, V0 by VD. What is V0? V0 is the output voltage. What is VD? VD is the difference voltage between the input. this is called as a common, this is called as a output gain or a differential gain. So we have one more thing that is called as common mode gain, AC. AC is nothing but VO by VC. Now what is this VC? VC is nothing but the average of two voltage at inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal, or average of common mode voltage. Normally, the common mode or operational amplifier should amplify difference voltage. It should not amplify common mode voltage. That means VC should, AC should be AC, or sorry, VC should be zero. That should, AC should be zero. That means common mode rejection ratio is nothing but the ratio of AD by AC. That is how it operational amplifier reject common mode signal. That is an indication of common mode rejection ratio. Theoretically, AC should be zero. When AC should be zero, for ideal operational amplifier, it tends to infinity, but practically it is not infinity. This is called as common mode rejection ratio. One more, one more parameter is PSSR, that is nothing else, power supply rejection ratio. What is power supply rejection ratio? Normally, when there is a change in the power supply signal, that is power supply voltage, that is VDD or VCC, etc., output should not change, but practically output changes. Suppose this is delta V is the change in the power supply, delta V is the change in the power supply, and V0 is the output, then power supply rejection ratio for positive changes, positive power supply variation, we are using two power supplies for operational amplifier, this is called as power supply rejection ratio. For similarly, power supply rejection ratio for negative variation in the power supply, negative power supply variation is nothing but variation in the power supply, negative power supply and output. So this is one more parameter. And the last parameter we are using is called as drift and offset. What do you mean by offset and drift? Now let us take operational amplifier. So this is our operational amplifier. We will take this as, this is inverting terminal and this is a non-inverting terminal. So this is inverting terminal and this is non-inverting terminal. This is the output. Here we are giving VI inverting, and here we are giving VNI, that is non-inverting. And this is nothing but our difference voltage VD. This is nothing but our difference voltage VD. And we are getting the output based on the open loop gain AD and VD. That is our output. That is nothing but our output V0. Now what will happen if I short this and this input terminals, if I short this input terminals, whether my output V0 is zero? No. The answer is no. If I short this input terminal, output is not zero. There is a small voltage at the output. So in order to correct that voltage, I will add I will add a correction voltage source at the input. I will add a correction voltage at the input. This is non-inverting and this is inverting. I will add correction voltage, whether it is a plus or minus, depending on it. And when I vary this voltage source, this I will call as a IOS. Voltage source, VIOS, voltage source. When I vary this one, I will vary this one to make the output is equal to zero. And normally this voltage is called as a drift or offset, drift or offset. So these are the important parameters of our operational amplifier.